you're not going to play with me, maybe you'll play with someone else. Oh dear, David. Lydia is in this weird age when she finds boys gross. You know what I mean? But let me tell you the secret. It's the dead boys that you find the most repelling.
It's Andy. Lydia. The girl I tried to rescue, she's alive, but she's not herself anymore. I've never seen something like this before. This poor girl. I think she doesn't see. When she turned her head in my direction, she didn't react. Listen, I've left the key next to the tape. With the screwdriver, you can open the vent. You can escape through it. The vent is behind the mannequin with a blue hand. Good luck.
Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep. Here in the forest, dark and deep, I offer you eternal sleep.
David woke up in the late evening and decided to visit his friend, Tom. Tom lived just around the corner, but David always took a shortcut through the backyard. He always sneaked out through the kitchen window. David didn't want to ask his mother for permission. He knew she wouldn't let him go. The stool he used to get on the worktop was gone.
Little sounds around the walls, creaks and bumps and scrapes and all. Shadows seem to come alive, bits and pieces left. Behind, more and more the darkness comes, you and me will have some fun. Scream. Screaming, now please don't be afraid. And polite. Oh, I think you deserve a treat. But before that, I have one more request for you. Would you kindly enter this box? If you do, I might think about letting you go. I just enter the box and maybe you'll be home before the supper. Leave your backpack on the chair, put out the candle, and enter this box. Leave your backpack on the chair, put out the candle, and enter this box. Now, now. Get inside that box. Well done, baby. I have to get you all ready for the meeting I've planned. I would be a very selfish man if I didn't share such a treasure like you. Oh, that's precious! Can you make that sound one more time? Perfect! Finally! The model with the voice function! Music to my ears! Please, don't stop. Don't you worry, David. In a little while, it will all be over.
David sneaked out of the house to see his friend. He had to take only a few steps through the rock bridge. Suddenly, he heard a voice.
Excuse me.
The stranger turned his head towards David and said,
"Do you know where house number 7 is?"
David didn't reply and just stared at the man. He couldn't say anything.
"Oh, don't be afraid. I'm the friend of your parents. Maybe we can go together,"
said the man. David wanted to run away, but suddenly someone grabbed him.